morning, students. Today we'll discuss the six lectures, that is same continuation in our fifth lecture, that is the quantity estimation of the storm water. Now after discussing with the theory classes last in fifth lecture, this in sixth lecture I will discuss some numerical problem solving that I will discuss for further clearing the concept of yours, because when you go for the, because as it is a chapter of the estimation part, you know, the estimation of the storm water, to definitely the quantity calculations, that is the numerical problems, if you solve, then only the concept will be clear most. So for that objectives, we have come here to solve some two examples which will clear our conception how to do the estimate of the storm water. So let me solve the first problem. The question given is, we have to calculate the design discharge of a combined system. Let me tell you what is the combined system. Combined system means the same sewer, same pipe, the sanitary sewage as well as the storm water, both is flow. Again, I repeat, the combined system means a single sewer system in which both the that means in a single pipe of big diameter, where both the sanitary sewage as well as the storm water will flow. That is the combined system. So that means while designing the sewerage system, you have to calculate first the sanitary sewage quantity, and you have to calculate the storm water discharge also, and then you have to add, because it is a combining flow in the same sewer, same pipeline, then you have to add the both discharge. So this is the objective of this problem, how to determine the design discharge for a combined system. That means separately, first you have to calculate the sanitary sewage, then you have to calculate the storm water, then you have to add to find out the design discharge for a combined system. So that is ultimately we have to find out. Now let us see the problem. Population is given as 50,000 in the problem, and the rate of water supply, that means I mean to say the domestic water supply, it is given as 135 liter per capita per day. This is as per the standard IS code. It is minimum required is 135 liter per capita per day. So that is been authorized this delivery of the water. I mean to say, not the unauthorized delivery, that is the authorized delivery that we have learned. Now the catchment area for which the drainage system, the sewerage and drainage system will be designed, the combined system will be designed, that the catchment area is said as 100 hectares, and the average coefficient of runoff is 0.6. It is given. Why it is average? Because the area to area fluctuation, because in a big area the area is subdivided and the coefficient of runoff is differed from place to place. So we are considering always the average quantity of runoff, that is 0.6. And the time of concentration for the design rainfall, it has already been highlighted in my fifth lecture, that is the last class. The time of concentration for the design rainfall is 30 minutes. That is the time required for starting the catchment area to contribute the runoff. At that, after that time, the catchment area discussed for will initiate, will contribute for starting the runoff. That is the thing. So that is 30 minutes is given, and the relation between the intensity rainfall and duration, as we have seen by empirical formula, I equal to A plus B plus T. A is given the constant value 1000 in the question, and B is also given the constant value 20 in the question. So considering knowing the T value, that is the time of concentration, we can easily calculate the intensity as per the question gives us the value. Now let us go for the solution part, how to solve this problem. Now first I will calculate the, I will show how to calculate the estimation of the sewerage quantity as per my lecture session on fourth lecture we have discussed. Then we will show how the estimation of the storm water discharge, that is in lecture 5, that is in the last lecture, previous class lecture we have given, and adding the two will arrive at the design discharge of a combined system. Now while calculating the sewage quantity, that is the sanitary sewage quantity which I am talking, definitely we have found that 70 to 80%. So let us consider the 80% of the water supply will be considered as a sewage. So first What is the funda? Funda is you have to first calculate the total water supply quantity, and out of that water supply quantity, the thumb rule is 75 to 80%. Let us consider here the 80% of that water supply will be considered as a sanitary sewage. That is the basic factor, and then you have to consider the peak factor for design as per the fluctuations. You have seen the daily fluctuations, hourly fluctuations. You have seen daily fluctuations, the peak factor is 2. You have seen the hourly fluctuations, the peak factor is 3. So average, here we can consider the peak factor of 2.5 in case of finding out the design discharge of the sanitary sewage. So what is the quantity of water supply? The water supply, it has been given is 135 liter per capita per day. So per capita means per person. So total person population, which how much population I have to serve? I am serving the population 50,000. So total quantity is 135 into 50,000. That is in gross total in liter. When we multiply is 20, because this is the supplied water. That means it is reached to the destination user, end user. So this water is supplied, but the whole water we are not using. So let us consider the 80% is being wasted water and 20% you are using. So 50,000 is the capita, that is the person, and the 135 liter per capita. That means if we multiply liter per capita into capita, that means it gives us the in liter. So that we are doing 135 into 50,000 will give the total liter in water which is supplied to us. Into 80%, that means into 28, that will go to the sewer line. That means that gives the wastewater, that is the sewage water which are finding out. Now the quantity which will be found out, multiply 50,000 into 135 into 0.8, that will give in liter per day. And if you divide by 3,000, if we divide by 1,000, then ultimately I will get the figure meter cube per day, because 1 meter cube is 1,000 liter. So ultimately, the whatever the value divided by 1,000 will give you the meter cube, and the value coming 5,400 meter cube per day. Further, it will be transferred into the meter cube per second, because in design calculation, mostly in sewage design calculation, our end aim for transferring the value into meter cube per second. So divided by 3600, it ultimately will give you 0.0625 meter cube per second. Why 3600? Because one day, divided by 24, divided by 3600. One day means 24 hour. So divided by 24, you will get the per hour. And then divided by 60, that means divided by 3600, will give meter cube per second. So this is the conversion I have told you. Now finally, when we are talking for the design discharge for the sanitary sewage, that means our design of the sewage will be done based on the design value. That design factor we have to consider 2.5, as you have seen earlier in my lecture, that the fluctuations in the demand, that is the hourly demand, daily demand, we have seen daily demand, we have seen the peak factor 2, hourly demand, we have seen the peak factor 3. So let us consider in this problem in design system, since it is not given in any question, you can have an assumption for designing the system. So let us consider the peak factor is 2.5. So 2.5 peak factor, considering the design discharge of the sanitary sewage, is coming as 0.156 meter cube per second. Now one part I have done in combined sewage, I have already told you it is a combination of the sanitary sewage and the storm water. So sanitary sewage part we have taken care. Now we are going to find out the storm water discharge. First, I will find out the rainfall intensity. The formula which is given, the empirical formula already given the values of A and B. A is 1000 and B is T. That means 1000 divided by T plus 20, but T is in minute. It is given in the question, that is the T means 30 minutes, yes. That is the time of concentration, 30 minutes is given. So putting the value of T equal to 30, what we get, I, that is the intensity of rainfall in millimeter per hour, that is the I equal to 1000 divided by 30 plus 20, that means 1000 by 50, ultimately it gives 20 millimeter per hour. So intensity of rainfall ultimately gives us 20 millimeter per hour. Then storm water flow, which is the rational formula, I have already shown you the logical formula, Q equal to CIA divided by 360. So C is 0.6, it is given in the average coefficient runoff. I is just now I have found out from the empirical formula, that is a 20 millimeter per hour. A is 100, why 100? Because the 100 hectare is given, and this formula will be applicable if area in hectare. Because in square kilometer, then the formula will be 0.278 that I have shown earlier lecture. Since the hectare is given, so divided by 360 we have to consider. Yes, definitely it has been considered, catchment area has been told as 100 hectares in the question. So that's why we have used the area is 100 hectares, and we have used the conversion factor 360. As I have discussed in my earlier lecture, the rational formula CIA divided by 360, converting, giving the value of 3.33 meter cube per second. That is the storm runoff. Remember, my dear students, that whenever we are going to calculate the storm of the storm water runoff, then we will not multiply with any peak factor, because here the actual flow we are finding out, there is not no question of the fluctuation. So peak factor multiplication will be applicable only for the sanitary sewage estimation, not for the storm water. Storm water actually Q equal to CIA from the rational formula, but actually we are getting that formula is final, no peak factor will be multiplied with this. This is the difference between the estimation of the design discharge of the sanitary sewage and the stormwater discharge. So in this case, again I am telling, stormwater discharge will not taking care any multiplication or peak factor like we have used in the sanitary sewage. This is the thing, major difference we have. Ultimately, two design discharge after finding out separately, we have to add the two things, because two flow will flow into the single sewer, which is called the combined sewer. So we are interested, we are asked to find out the design discharge of the combined sewer. Definitely the sanitary sewer, that is 0.156, I mean to say the design discharge of the sanitary sewer will be added to the stormwater flow, that is 3.33, and find will give us the final value 3.49 meter cube per second as a design discharge of the combined sewer. So question one is, ultimately we have shown you how to calculate the design discharge in the combined sewer. So separately we have found out the design discharge of the sanitary sewer, then we have found out the stormwater runoff, and adding these two, why adding these two? Because two flow will be occurring in the single pipeline in a combined sewer system. So that's why we have added the two flow, and this is asked in the question to find out, that is the design discharge of the combined sewer. Some type of different problem, problem number two now we'll discuss for clearing your conception further. Because we are today in this lecture class, we are discussing the numerical part, how to find out the estimation of the sanitary sewage as well as the combined sewage covering the as well as the stormwater sewage. So that has been taken care. Let us consider problem number two, that is the catchment area is given as 300 hectares. The surface covered in catchment can be classified as, in the table, the various areas are given. You see first the table, then I am telling. First, at a glance, I have shared my note. You see the table, then I will tell. I hope by this time you have seen the whole table, what it gives the, I have given you the time to see the tables, because this table is very important, because type of cover it is mentioned, whether it is roof, pavement and yards, towns and gardens, roads, open ground, single family dwelling. So these type of things are given, and corresponding coefficient runoff value also given, and the percentage area is also given. Percentage area means total area, if you summation is considered as 100, that means roofs, but pavements, yards, lawns, gardens, roads, open ground, single family dwelling. If summation we consider as 100%, then what is the roofs, what is the pavement, that individual percentage also is given. You just have a look, please. So this table, I think it is clear to you that OBC and runoff also given and the percentage given. You see the lawns and gardens, it is seen that the ultimately when you are seeing the problem, so there will be some practical implicacy also there. You have to study and you have to gain the experience, because lawns and gardens means it is the greenery area. It is the soil condition. Definitely the surface of runoff, I repeatedly told you earlier, it is less because the water percolates under the ground. Similarly, open ground, that is also soil condition, so water percolates into the water. But if you see the roofs, definitely it is a waterproof roof, water will not be able to percolate, so definitely it is a very high surface runoff. 90% you have considered. Pavement and ears also you have considered 90%. Lawns and gardens, they are also greenery area, soil condition is there, so water will percolate under the ground, so the runoff will be less, so the coefficient runoff also will be less. So what we can see in this problem, different area, different even in a building portion, the different areas are shown, outside area also shown, and different runoff, coefficient runoff and the percentage of area also shown to calculate what? This will help us to calculate the average coefficient runoff, that this problem will teach us how to, that solution of the this typical problem will teach us how to solve the average coefficient runoff of the area if the individual area and if the individual corresponding area's coefficient runoff is given. That is needed. It is very much needed to calculate. Fine. And without this coefficient runoff, you can't apply the rational formula CIA. So first you have to find out the C. That will be very beginning in be reflected in your mind. So I think you have gone through the table first. So I have given you the time to show these things. Now, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the quantity storm runoff. not only the C, what value you will require? You require the C value that we will calculate from this tabular form that you have already studied, you have gone through this table. Then coming to the point of I, that means the intensity of rainfall that is given in the question, monitoring, it is already given in the question. And A, obviously the A means the catchment area. That area definitely it is given in the question. At the top it is given in the question, the catchment area is 300 hectares in the beginning. So C will be known, I is given, A is given. So you can find out the storm water, you can estimate the storm water. Now coming to the point is, if the population density in the area, population, whenever this terminology in the any problem is given, the population, that means population is for water supply. That means they are the sanitary sewage is coming. Population, the word is associated with computation of the sanitary sewage plant. So when the population density in the area is given, that means the population density means population into area, total population you will get. And it is also given per capita per liter, how much water is supplied, 200 liter. So you can calculate the total liter and you can 75% to 80% you can consider as a sanitary sewage after calculation of the total water. So in that way you can calculate the separate system means when I am talking for the separate system, that means the stormwater sewage is different and the stormwater is different and the sanitary sewage is different. Partially separate system means, as I have discussed in my earlier note, partially means some portion of the stormwater we are including into the sanitary sewage. What is that? That is the roots portion and the pavement and ears that I have earlier clarified in my earlier lecture. When you are talking for the partially separate system, that means some portion of the stormwater, that means which are falling on the roofs, pavements and ears, that will also allow to pass into the sewage system, sanitary sewage system. So that will consider how to calculate the partial sewage system. And finally, the combined system, as we have seen in my problem one in this lecture, that is adding the sanitary sewage and the stormwater. So let us solve the problem. So three answers you have to calculate, three discharge from the separate system, for the partially separate system and the combined system. So first of all, we have to calculate the C value for stormwater discharge or you have to very beginning you have to see the tabular value. I have already shown and giving the time to go through that study to the table, and from this table how the C value will be calculated, because we know C value, average C value of the whole area is calculated based on the weighted average sigma AC divided by sigma A. What is sigma AC? Because we don't require the actual area. Let us consider the whole area as 100%. Whole area as A. Now the portion percentage you can consider 0.5, and corresponding multiplication will be done by the constant C value. I am just giving one example. First table, first point is 0.9. And what is the percentage area? 0.15. So you just write 0.15 into 0.9, because 0.15 is the percentage of the whole area. Ultimately, area numerator and denominator will be cancelled. So you can consider the percentage. So if the whole area is A, so percentage means 0.15 A, that will be the numerator. In denominator also will be total A, so A will be vanished. So ultimately you can compute, you can go on the computation based on the percentage basis. So 0.15 into 0.9 plus 0.15 into 0.8, and go on this. Last is shown in the tabular form, 10%. So 0.1 into 0.5 ultimately divided by 1, because whole area is 1. If I go by the percentage, then whole area is 1, because if you go in denominator summation of, if you go on summation of that 0.15, 0.25, 0.25, ultimately it will give you 1. So divided by 1, weighted average is giving you, it is simply just weighted average, C1A1, C2A2 divided by sigma A. So it gives us 0.44. That is the average value of the surface runoff of the whole area. So quantity of stormwater, let us see the quantity of stormwater is CIA divided by 360. Again, that Asaran formula which you used in the problem one. In problem two also we will use the same formula, because area is shown in the hectare. And what that catchment area is told in this question is 300 hectare. So C value 0.44, 30 millimeter per hour already given in the question, 300 hectare the catchment area, that means where the rain falls, that area is also given in the question, divided by 360, the conversion factor. Since area is hectare, it is given in the question, so we will use the 360. Because to convert the figure in meter cube per second, and what discharge value we are getting, 11 meter cube per second, we are quantity of stormwater we are getting. Estimation of sewage discharge for separate system of sanitary sewer. Now, in separate system of sanitary sewer, that means there is a separate system of sanitary sewer, means we have to calculate the sanitary sewage quantity separately. Again, the sanitary sewage will depend on the quantity of water supplied to the population. And total quantity of water supplied, that 80%, 0.8, will be multiplied on the total quantity supplied. Then we will get the sanitary sewage, because we are considering on an average that sanitary sewage is nothing but 75 to 80% of the total water supply, authorized water supply. That I would use the terminology authorized water supply. Unauthorized water we are not taking. So that's why you are taking average 75 to 80%. So 0.8 has to be multiplied to the total quantity of water supply. Total quantity of water supply, how can consider, because in the question it is given the population density is 350 persons per hectare and the area is 300 hectare. So total population is 350 into 300. If total population is 350 into 300, then what is the total water? Water is given 200 liter per capita per day. That is given. So capita, that means a person is 300 into 350. Then into 200 will give the total quantity of water. It is per day supply. And ultimately multiplying with 0.8, it will convert it into wastewater, which will be going to the sanitary sewage. So this is ultimately coming after converting unit 0.194 meter cube per second. So once again I am telling, whenever you are analyzing any problem related with the sanitary sewage, always use the peak factor 2 to 2.5. So similarly, considering the peak factor of 2, the design discharge of the sewer is 0.389 meter cube per second. Because we are talking for the separate system of sanitary sewer, so the answer will be 0.389 meter cube per second. Now, the second part of the answer, first part answer, answer we have solved. Second part of the answer, we have to find out the quantity for discharge for the partial separated system. Partial separated system means the quantity of sewage will be same. That is the 0.389. That will not change. What will change? What will be added with this 0.389? Some flow of storm water which will covering the roof and courtyards. So, for roof and courtyards, 300, the area, how much area is we have to consider? Now, 300 up to 300, the 15%, let me go to the table. Then will be understood. If we go to the table, in table, the roofs covers 15%. 15% total area is given in the question is 300. So, 300, 15% means 45. So, 45 we have taken as an area. So, 45 hectare, I mean to say, 300 hectare was given by the total area. 300 hectare, if is the total area, then 15% of 300 is how much? 45 hectare. So, 45 hectare for roof as well as pavement and piers, 45 hectare for pavement and piers, that you have to consider because both are shown in the table is 15%. So, 45 area will be considering for the when you are going to find out the quantity of storm water, that means 45 into 0.9 plus 0.8 into 45 divided by 90. 90, why 90? Because we are going to calculate the average sea value on the roof and the courtyard. So on the roof, the value is 45 area. On the courtyard, the value is 45. So total 90. So divided by total 90, again, we have applied the weighted average formula for finding out the sea value of the roof and the courtyard. Why we have taken only roof and courtyard? Because the storm water falling onto the roof and courtyard only will be taken into account for the partially separate system, means that will be added, that will be added to the sanitary sewage. So discharge will, what will be discharge? CISM rational formula will be applied. So C value is 0.85, I is given in the question 30, A is 90, considering the two of area, courtyard and the roof. So ultimately it will give to 6.375 meter cube per second. So this 6.375 meter cube per second discharge coming from the storm water through the roof and the courtyard will be adding to the sanitary sewage, as because this is the partially separate system. Partially separate system means the presence of the partially separate system here will consider the sanitary sewage along with the storm water of the roof and courtyard part. So ultimately in the partially separate system, the discharge will be coming 6.375 plus 0.389, that is the 6.74 meter cube per second. And what will be the storm water drain? If we consider storm water drains, that will be, we have seen that total is 11. Total discharge of the quantity of storm is 11. And out of that, the 6. Out of that, the partial system considers is 6.375. So balance will be the in the storm water drains. Balance will be in the storm water drains, that is the 4.625, because total storm water quantity is, again I am telling, total water storm quantity we have calculated 11. So out of that, in partially separated system, it is coming 6.375 from the roof and courtyard. So balance 4.625, 11 minus 4.625, that will be the discharge in the storm water drains. I hope today's session is very interesting, as we have solved the numerical problems, how to calculate the storm water, how to calculate the sanitary sewage water. We have separately seen the separately in problems, separately we have highlighted to calculate how to calculate in the separate sewage system, how to calculate in the combined system, how to calculate the storm drainage independently. So that all the things I have shown you. So I think you have enjoyed the session. So you go through my lectures, definitely I will give another numericals, same line of numericals to you for your assignment to further solving. First, I request your guys to go through my lecture notes, to go through the numericals which you have solved and earlier lecture along with my earlier theoretical lectures. Then only we'll come again with some assignments with similar nature of problems for further solving. Thank you. All the best. Thank you.